A lot of changes have taken place here, both on and off the track. And a group of fans right now would like to say a big thank you to the two mainstays behind all of this, Mr. Fred and his wife, Debbie Brownfield, race fans.
Ladies and gentlemen, a number of us got together and we wanted to say thanks to Fred and Debbie. We wanted to give them a little something for their wall at home. So this is thanks for the 94 season. And all the very best of luck in 95. And we want to thank you especially for the Outlaw Show and all of our local drivers and sponsors and crews as well. Thank you very, very kindly.
Around the speedway, Dennis, our head flagman, Kirby Hoyle alongside, tell the drivers one more time around. As the sun begins to set, tip the caps back, take off the glasses, and watch this economy semi-main event for seven laps of racing. What a beautiful night it is. As we wait for the green flag, we're underway. Evening. So Clint Roy Blumenhagen, car number 14. Nice to see Roy back behind the wheel here at Skagit Speedway in the Jim Dietz prepared number 14 car. We move up two cars. It'll be a six lap race.
Speedway.
Get up the victory. 360 season championship trophy dash. Underway. Beaver will go up top. And can he take the lead? Let's watch him. Wing away. And a three and off a four. Yes, and then Beaver race fans, look at this. Back and forth, Beaver takes the lead. Speedway. Two laps down and two to go. Houston hanging top. It's Billy Beaver, your leader. The Neon 91 car. Top of the fourth turn. White flag. One lap to go. Fletcher and Smith running third and fourth. Get a three and up a four. Trophy dash win for Billy Beaver. Houston second. Fletcher third. And Jay Smith in the number four spot. 52 years old out of Bellingham, Gene Quans. Standard match race format, best two out of three laps for your top two in the late model standing, Smith and Quans. Green flag. The Ford power of Gene Quans, car number 11 up top, takes the lead. Can he make it all the way around? Yes, he will. There it is. Rick Smith this time looks like he's going to force a third lap. Yes, he will. So this time, here we go. Skagit Outlaw late models, Rick Smith. Off and running. Your 94 champion will win the match race. Two laps to one. Rick Smith over Gene Quans. And what we should do is leave those two cars on the track. 94. Maybe not for the final time in 94. We'll try it again. Again, the flagman, just as the match races. Lap
of three and a half of four. Your winner, Mark Houston. Shauna Wilski and Alan Bond. Those of you wondering, no points are awarded for the trophy. We got Gary Rail all buckled in, and unfortunately for him, we won't need him now, as both the 92 of Cram and the 17 of Hawthorne have made it onto the track. 18 cars scheduled for 30 laps. Your Economy Sprint Championship main event underway. Race car. For the second time. Plate Chevrolet Pace Track to the pit area. Green flag. Yellow flag. So the mid one-night ride of 18-year-old Travis Cram. It looks like it's come to an end. He fought his way. Green flag, here we go. Under yellow with Martinez in turn number two. Again, a tough break for Martinez, along with Dills and Loy and Crab, all having problems through that event. And action back underway.
Here comes your but we'll be back next year. We'll see what happens.
Thanks a lot, Jeff.
Thank you.
As we get ready for the 30-lap late model feature, 13, Harold Dyer, the 7 car, Charles Randall, 2, Terry Neuendorf, Janet Scheck, Nelson, and the 71 car of Severson. We're underway. Also with the problem power as we get ready for green flag again. There it is. flag the next time around. And there it is, one more lap to go for the 25-year-old driver. Using caution as he comes up on the slower cars down the backstretch. Quads and Powers still running second and third. Off of third for your winner, Rick Smith. Second to Quads and third to Powers. As they take the checkered flag for the final time this year, that of Tenbrink, Jones, and Flamag, and the rest of your late model field. So Rick Smith goes flag to flag, pole to pole, with his eighth main event victory of the season. Again, it's a 16-point lead in the standings for Houston in the 73 over Burrow in the 1B. They start side by side on the front row. Houston or Burrow, they're on the front row as we get ready for the green flag for this historic night. We're underway. Your early In turn number two, red flag, he's out of the car. Apparently okay. 21 complete, 14 to go. Green flag.
'60s in the 410s. Before we get to late car race fans, how about a nice round of applause for one of the hardest working pit crews? There they are, the Houston Motors Racing Team. Out of the hand for them. And he's got his helmet off. Your 1994 360. Your 1994 410. Skagit Speedway champion, Mark Houston. And the season's not even over yet. Four or five races to go. As we said, he won $6,000 up in Edmonton, Alberta. Less than 24 hours ago, he drove 15 hours to be here tonight. He takes home the $1,200 payment. Janae Kipkes, Sarah Hollis, Angela Von Berg, Rose Miller, and Diana Clementson all winning the Mark Houston in terms of all-time career points races here at Skagit Speedway, the 360 and 410 classes. Burrow, of course, will third time the 360 championship win, taking over 50. Race fans,
Your top three finishers in tonight's feature race.
Where's the champagne, Mark?
Bobby Pearl and Randy Red. Show out for these guys.
Don't fall backwards because you go right through.
You want us up here?
Bobby go home? Okay, who's that? Stock cars? What do you want, Bob?
360.
Okay, where's your 360 people?
What division have we got next?
Beaver.
360s?
360s.
Okay, folks, bring the Houstons back into the spotlight once again.
I'm going off again. It's hard to hold on.
Damn on you,
man.
They're
setting me up again.
I don't think that's okay.
Yeah, it really was. Like I said earlier, I really enjoy racing with Jeff for the past all year and suffered a lot of hard luck. He ought to get the hard luck award. And it makes up for the first weekend. I was leading and broke and he won. So wait, you know, it goes around and comes around. A little bit of luck.
What is it?
Hey, about the rest of the season for you? Where are you going
to be? We don't have any plans right now. We're building a trailer and planning on traveling a little bit next year. So we'll just be busy. We may go down to Chico for the 360 show. We don't have any 410 stuff now. But we're going to work hard all winter rebuilding for next year. Probably follow Houston around. You know, he's got a lot of his 360 stuff in the Northwest. And it sounds like a lot of fun.
There's a lot of people following the 360.
Yeah.
Congratulations on a great ride tonight. Bullet balls, new rules
really
this year, a tremendous season of racing, faster laps than we have ever seen turned here at the Speedway by these cars.
Too big. There you go.
Can't hear you. Get out of the way.
And a great, great year. Competition.
Say Bud Light, Gene.
Hey, Ricky's going to a different class next year. Yay!
Spot. All of the event wins this year. The
Prairie.
The season. Prairie.
Come here, Rick.
That's it?
That's all you get.
You never don't
know me. Oh, I get a beer. I'm not going to come up and kiss you either.
No?
No.
Rick Smith, another round of applause for your late model stars, Rick Smith, Gene Plons, and Mike Powers.
Thank you, ladies.
Well, Rick Smith, nothing with having comes easy, and you guys have worked real hard for this championship.
Yeah, I just like to start out with thanking my brothers, my dad, my mom, who built this car from scratch and ground up, and all my sponsors helped out to get the car here. It was a great season. It really worked great. It's hard on you. This is the hardest we've ever worked for anything.
Well, the car was absolutely flawlessly oriented.
It was faster than that.
Okay, what about
Yeah, I think this was probably the last time I see the LA Mall. I'm thinking about switching to the sprint cars. I'm open to suggestions for whatever happens.
Okay, have you sold your car or is it for sale?
It's for sale. Might have it sold, might not. It all depends on what's going on.
So if anybody wants to buy a really fast late model, maybe you're not going to have it available.
Could be, but we're open if they want to pay the right price.
Yeah, we're looking at price.
Yeah, it's definitely going to cost a lot of money. You need to get a lot more sponsors. Late models is, it's a good class. A lot of great drivers in there. And
Okay, now let's see. Economies.
Where's all the economies? Okay, we need the economy sprints, please.
You didn't forget how to get up there, though, did you?
Yeah, the old lady up there. Just about wrapped up, man. Then you'll be all invited to the area.
That's it. Come here, Matt. One more time.
It's only 10:30. We wrap things up. My gosh, Dave Hale, back there to you, Matt Loving.
Well, Matt Loving. Okay, let's talk a little bit about your race car.
Yeah, I got last year from Danny Burke. We talked to him here during the outlaw.
Okay, your first year of racing, was it what you expected it was going to be?
I didn't think that would be this competitive. You know, at the start of the year, I was happy with 10th in points, but second's great. Can't go wrong.
What do you attribute all that success
to? Definitely all my brothers, my sponsors, my picture of the
Okay, so what was the highlight of the season until tonight?
Where's Jason Solo?
Race fans, if you're wondering why Bobby Burrow is up there, remember earlier this year, Leo Ford drove the 73 car.
I want to get out of the way.
So, in effect, if you're close to drivers only, Bobby Burrow is the driver champion. Houston Racing Team are the owner's champions. So there they are. Smith, Houston. Now what's going on back there? They're probably drinking it. Anyways, we saw Leo Boyd drove the 73 car that 1 week, so Houston.